electric field due to a infinite plane sheet. So let's draw it. Assume this is a plane sheet having uniformly charged and I'm assuming this charge is positively charged. We want to find out electric field at a point of P. So before to start, surface charge density sigma, area A means each area is A. Now what will be the Gaussian surface, because we will apply Gauss theorem to find out this electric field. In many books you can find out this Gaussian surface is a cylinder. Now I will suggest that Gaussian surface you can consider in the form of cube also. There is no problem. I mean cuboid. Here, like this way. Why I am thinking for this cuboid? Because as it is a cuboid, so from each and every point, this surface means this surface contains equal distance and it follows Gauss theorem. Means the condition for Gaussian surface. Even we consider along this side as a Gaussian surface, but it's not the right because it's a plane sheet. As it is a plane sheet, so both the side contain this charge, positive charge. So in the opposite side there also will be field, means the field line as it is passing. So the opposite side also we have to draw this Gaussian surface which will be equal distance, means if it is r then this distance also will be r. So this is the case. So area, which area we will consider for the app for the equations of Gauss theorem? Of course this area A and this area A. Why not this? These are the things, because these are not following the Gaussian surface conditions. So that's why we will consider only these two area. Now apply the same thing, there is no problem. Integral of E dot ds equal to Q by epsilon naught. This is the formula, we all know these things. Now we have to consider a small area. Let us consider this is the area ds and area vector ds will be along this direction. Electric field is also along the same direction. Why electric field along the same direction? Because it is a positively charged and electric field line will be just outward and it will be perpendicular to this surface. Therefore the angle between these two theta is nothing but 0 degree. Therefore E dot ds means E ds of cos 0 degree equal to Q by epsilon naught, integral of course. Now E we want to find out, that's why out of integration. Ds is simply we can write 2a, why this is 1a and here is another a. So that's why 2a equal to Q by epsilon naught and cos 0 value is 1. So that's why we are neglecting, we can neglect these things. Therefore E electric field equal to Q by 2a epsilon naught. Again one thing we can do for this case, Q by 2a epsilon naught, Q equal to we can write sigma into a by 2a, sigma into A by 2A of epsilon naught. A cancel out. Therefore, it will be sigma by 2 epsilon naught. This is electric field. The most interesting things for this, E equal to sigma by twice epsilon naught. E is electric field and it's a vector. Now, what will be the direction? E equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught of A cap or S cap. Means this S cap. So, from this, one can easily say this electric field is independent of this distance R, because this electric field does not contain any type of distance value, means R or X or whatever it is. So the fact, total fact, E equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught A is uniform electric field, means the plane sheet always emit a uniform field, means there will be no such change. Now, if anyone want to know about the graph or graphical representation of electric field with distance for this plane sheet, then the graph will be like this. Here, along this direction, R means distance, and this is electric field, and its value will be uniform, where this value is nothing but sigma by 2 epsilon. I hope it's clear to you. Now what about this case for infinite plane sheet only, but the sheet contains some thickness. In case of this thickness, only one thing we will do. Here, for thickness, this charge value Q equal to sigma into 2A, means it's not A. Therefore, electric field will change to sigma by epsilon naught in the same way. And this electric field E equal to sigma by epsilon naught is known as Coulomb's law. Also known as Coulomb's law. In higher studies, you will get this. Yes. Okay. Once again, a new case. Electric field due to a charge cell. Charge Q and radius R. This is the cell. Cell means this contain charge only on this surface. Inside this is free, and outside also the free. Means there are three different positions in which we can find out electric field. Number one, here is P1, suppose, means inside the cell. Number two, P2, on the cell. And number three, P3, outside the cell. So let's proceed with the first case, inside the cell. Inside the cell means P1. Now we have to draw a Gaussian surface. Of course, this Gaussian surface will be a sphere. Therefore, E dot ds equal to Q by epsilon naught. Now, Q equal to 0. Therefore, electric field equal to 0. Simple case. Means as it does not contain any type of charge, so, charge will be 0 as well as electric field also will be 0. Okay. Now, on the surface means, again, let's draw once again. This is the electric field, spherical cell, radius R, charge is here. Now, in this case, Gaussian surface will be the same surface because it is nothing but the surface of the spherical shell only. Therefore, integral of E dot ds equal to q by epsilon naught. Now let's draw a ds vector. This is ds vector. Even electric field also will be the along the same direction. Therefore, E into ds means 4 pi capital R square equal to q by epsilon naught, and hence it proceeds to E equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by R square. Now here R is nothing but the radius. This is on the surface. And third case, outside the surface. Outside the surface, closed integral of E dot ds equal to q by epsilon naught. These things is common for every problem. Now, in this case, let's once again draw this. Here, capital R is the cell and positive charge, and let P3 is this point, and we have to draw a Gaussian surface. Again, no need to, I hope no need to explain about these things. This Gaussian surface also will be a sphere. Now let us assume this is small r. Therefore, E into, this ds vector and electric field will be along the same direction again, means theta will be 0 here also. Therefore, E into 4 pi small r square equal to q by epsilon naught, and hence it will proceed as E equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Okay, so if we want to draw a graph based on these three, the first case, suppose E1, E2 and here E3. So let's once again proceed with these three. E1 is 0, E2 means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Here in this case, small r is actually capital R, and E3 is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by small r square. Now in this case, one can write r greater than r. Now r square, so it must follow a hyperbolic nature. So the graphical representation will be like this. From this, to a finite capital R, suppose there is no electric field, and suddenly at this point we'll get a electric field which is maximum. Suppose this, and from this again electric field will gradually decrease, and it will go on. It will never be zero, but it will decrease. Here electric field 1 by r square, and here electric field at this point 1 by capital R square. That's all this graphical representation for this case. Some numerical problem. Number one, listen carefully. Let us assume two plane sheet both are having positively charged, and surface charge density for the first plate sigma A. Let us assume this plate is A and this plate is B, and here sigma B, positive, positive. Now we'll get three different position, number 1, 2, 3. for these three different cases, what will be the electric field? For the first, number one, for sigma A or for the A plate, electric field will be outward, means as it is a plate, so from this plate electric field will be along this direction as well as along this direction. Now as it is a positive x-axis, so the field will be plus sigma A by twice epsilon naught, whereas this side will be minus sigma A by twice epsilon naught. Similarly for sigma B also, plus sigma B by 2 epsilon naught, and along this direction minus sigma B by twice epsilon naught. So you don't consider that in this first region there will be no effect of sigma B, means there also will be some effect of sigma B, means therefore the plate B. So we'll get two field, one is minus sigma A by twice epsilon naught as well as minus sigma B by twice epsilon naught. Therefore electric field E is, we can consider EA plus EB is nothing but minus 1 by 2 epsilon naught of sigma A plus sigma B. Simple. Now in this case, the second position in this case for sigma A, it will be along this direction, of course it will be positive for A, and for B will be along this direction, of course it will be negative because it's a negative x-axis and this one is positive x-axis. So electric field E1 suppose, and here is E2, simple, we can write 1 by 2 epsilon naught of sigma A minus sigma B. And for the third region, for this case, A is positive as well as for B is also positive. Therefore, for the third region, one can write E3 equal to 1 by 2 epsilon naught of sigma A plus sigma B. Like this way also, you can consider this sigma B or this sigma A, any one of this can be negative. Means suppose sigma B is negative, means negatively charged. So for that case, electric field direction will be changed. Okay, so you just try to solve this. If you face any problem, then we will do it in the next class. So that's all for today. You just go through it, and some problem today I will give it in WhatsApp as well as this Telegram. And next class, maybe today evening, I will upload one more video based on this one. Thank you. Have a great day.